powered by BroadNet Concepts.
Because we have our shot already, so so let's do some portrait. But I want everybody to sit, right? I want everybody to sit. If you are at the back, is this him talking? So I want everybody to sit. Even if you are at the back, I want you all to sit. Can we all go back to our seats? Please, let's go back to our seats so that we can get a good portrait. So this space is a typical place that a lot of us will say is not a good place for portraits. Yeah, but let's just see what we can do, right? So I want to use this light at the back. I think it's a good one. The back light is a good one. So typically, when I want to shoot, when I'm starting a shoot, I shoot without my camera and I see, without my flash, and I see what I can get with that. So if it's not good enough, then I add light. But typically, 60 to 80% of my pictures, if it's outdoor or in the hotel, I don't use flash, except I need to, you know, And then the only case where I will use flash is if I'm trying to overpower another light that is behind the couple, or if I'm trying to get the background. So if, for example, they are outdoor, and then the sky is really nice, and I don't want it to be blown out, then I use the flash. But if not, I'm better off without my flash because I have less work to do, you know. Yeah, but most these days, most reception, you see that the lights and everything is properly placed, and you just want to, you know, create that mood light effect that the mood light people have set up. You know, you want to ensure that that same effect is in your photo, and that's why you only use lights. So typically, this will be my couple, and you know, the first time I'm meeting them, I usually call the bride Mr. So what's your name? Sorry. Okay, so Mr. Sheung and Julia. So those are our couples for today. So nice meeting you guys. My name is Jide Odukoya. You know, I can't hug you guys now. So you know, but I hope you guys are going to make it easy for me. Yeah. Okay. Good. So. Nice dance step. So it's time for our portrait. So there's nothing on my head. Like, I'm not thinking of whether this light is good or that one is good. I just want to get the moment. I want to get them in, you know, I want to get them going first. So here we're going to take over 500 pictures, you know. Just keep going, keep taking till I sense that they are tired. And once they are tired, I will say, okay, we're good. We're good to go. On to the next one, you know.
Far away, miles away, far away, to a place where no one can retain our play. Let's go far away, miles away, far away, to a place where no one can retain our play. Away, 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 away. One time. Ladies and gentlemen, just the way you do your videos and pictures, don't forget to tag us on social media platforms, NPC Expo 2021, hashtag NPC Expo 2021. Record it, take pictures, post it on your social media platforms. Thank you.
Nobody knows. Open Don't wanna see you with anybody. I'm getting jealous already. I'm getting jealous. Don't wanna see you with anybody. I'm getting jealous already. Getting addicted, oh boy. Getting addicted, oh baby. Getting addicted, oh boy. Getting addicted to you. Getting addicted, oh boy. Getting addicted, oh baby. Getting addicted, oh boy. Getting addicted, oh baby. My world is getting dancing after you. My world is getting chasing after you. Jump banana to you go, 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 jump banana to you go. If them pen get to me, I go tell them say lie. On you, special type of feeling when I feel when I'm with you. All the money, anytime we are there with you. I want to learn. I can't let you go. I'm beginning to begin to fall in love.
Guys, every photographer should please concentrate on what Mr. Jide is doing. Don't just look at the couples dancing. Focus on what Mr. Jide is doing. This is the practical session. Thank you.
Love is like me.
Love is my life, the love of my life.
Making my wife, I'm making my wife. Not find someone like you. Nothing I can do.
I used to like to miss you, but I've always been a player. I'm to mess up nice on you.
I might not make me fall in love. Fall in love. Fall in love. I know you don't make me fall in love.
Please, can we all go back to our seats? Can we all go back to our seats, please? Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, may we please be seated. May we please be seated.
Mm-hmm.
Ladies and gentlemen, please, we like everyone, please be seated. Thank you so much. So we can have the full attention of Mrs.
pictures, and so there are some pictures I took earlier now, so okay, so I think we started from here. So as you can see, you see that some those are lights. So these are my test shots when I started without flash, and then I'm using fast raw viewer. It views your raw easily, although you have to pay for it, but it's very cheap. And then so I will just go through these pictures on the spot and, you know, pick out the best ones. So these are some of the pictures, and then as you scroll through the pictures, you can also check if they are sharp. Can you see that is stark sharp? But again, these are very good pictures, but I really do not care, you know. I want to pick just the best and the best, you know. So out of all these dancing pictures, maybe three, I will end up picking like three or four,
You know, yeah, I'm that brutal, you know, when it comes to. Yeah, I like animation there. Let me see if it's focused. It's not focused, so that goes into the cycle. Okay, maybe this one. Yeah, I think that's in focus. Yeah. So I'm just going to pick that. Nah. Can you see the videographer is right in my shot? That's not a bad one, but I won't pick it. We'll still find a good one. Yeah, this should have been the best one, but the sax guy was not. Ha, that is it. Yeah.
So this is showing the sax guy's face. Can you see my mouse? And then
she's just singing to the rhythm. So I'm going to pick that. And then I try to focus on the sax guy as well to see if there's going to be any moment there. Yeah. Okay. Maybe that one. You can see the gesture on her hand. So I'm gonna pick that one. And then it's two hands as well. Can you see? The movement is in the hand. Right? So I'm gonna pick that one. And then a guy was looking like what's happening here? So this is the couple looking like they want to kiss. So that's the moment, so I'm just going to pick it. So she's a very difficult bride. She keeps looking down, you know, moving away from the camera, but let's see if there's any good moment. So as I said, I tried to do full length, short, full length, you know, bust, you know, and all that. I think that's a good one. Aha, that's it. That's it right there. Yeah, that's it. Oh, nice. Nice and easy. So my light guy is not experienced. That's why there's no light on the face. But, and you know what, when they are going down like that, I'll have told the guy to tilt it a bit so that my face is a bit exposed. But I like this moment because it went all the way down. And I think we can still recover some areas.
It's touch up, so.
Oh, that guy went off. Okay, that's a good one. Can you see the rope on the floor?
I think we can remove it now. Photoshop goes.
Okay, our face is nice.
So when I'm picking, I watch out for the placement of the hand if they are in awkward areas, you know. The eyes, if they are halfway closed, and then the lips. If it's not an emotion, if it's not a way that we see emotion, then that picture is going into recycle. Sometimes when someone closes their eyes, you know, their face is halfway closed, you know, their eyes are halfway closed, that kind of picture is recycle, even if it's a good moment. And that's why you have to take a lot.
I think I like this. The videographer was trying to get a moment there. This is the real shot. I like that. I like the hand. Can you see that hand? Can you see the moment in the hand? Yeah. Exactly. Fuck all the I didn't say that. Okay. And then this one I'll pick it for the videographer. That's it. Oh, that's it. Let's moment with the bride, but this one is good.
So can you see that I'm picking the ones that she opened her mouth, because those are moments of, they look like she's singing. But if it doesn't look like she's singing, if it just looks like, I won't pick it. But the moment goes with the swing of her hand, you know, and so I'll definitely pick that one.
I think she was reacting soon, yeah, so I'll pick it. Look at that smile. Very genuine. Okay, so this is the portrait part. So we started from a very simple portrait. So I tried to, this is not sharp, so it's going to recycle. Okay, yeah, maybe this. So I tried to put everybody in it. I mean, this is where we have anyway, so. But I think the red dress is a blend with the tablecloth here. So I'm going to pick that one. Is there any different moment here? No. Yeah, maybe this one. Yeah, I'll pick this. I like the way he's looking at. She's looking at him.
I don't like that smile there. Okay, yes, that's it. That's it. So there's a woman she's laughing too. And the groom is okay. Yeah, it's not too sharp. The focus is on the guy's head. By the way, you can see my okay. Oh, my something is right here. You can see it. Sorry. I think we can still manage this one. Oh, nice. I love this. Oh, it's not sharp. Recycle is not sharp. Oh, nice. I like that. I like the contrast. These guys are lobbing up here, and then this one is just pressing phone or something. Nice, that's the moment. And then look at this gesture now. Okay. No. Go on. Can we use this? So if you crop our hand away, our hand is doing nothing there. If you go really close like this, maybe yes. So usually this is the process of, it's not more than this for me, or it's not. Even though those ones are laughing, I will definitely pick like one or two from it.
I'll pick this one. But I think the real moment is when we draw the dress. That's the icing on the cake. Usually, that's what I will post first on Instagram. Or these days, I don't even just care again. That may be the last picture. Doesn't really matter. Yeah, maybe one of that. So, I'm not sure the first one was good. Let's go back to our first part. Yeah, maybe this one. So this also gives us a lot of chance to pull in our tummy. Can you see our tummy here? It's a bit bulging out. So now these days, the truth is that I retouch every picture. If it's a portrait, I retouch it. The tummy, the shoulders, the arm, you have to, pimples, you have to remove it. Hot spots on the face, you have to remove it. If not, young boys would color your business. The young boys are not smiling. They are going all the way out. Okay, so we picked one of that.
And then I did some really, really close shots. Okay. Yeah, maybe one of these. The one that his face is not showing, his eyes is not showing. Maybe one of these. So you're not trying to get a perfect light now, right? You can still edit, retouch, you know, balance every other thing later. But it's not more than this. So if you ask me now, within 30 minutes, we've gotten all we need. And then I think this is the real part that I really like. Yeah, that one. Yeah, that's another one. Yeah, that one. Look at that one. It's probably my best. And then the portrait. There's really nothing than getting the portrait, yeah? But the picture is a bit blown out, if you look at it very well. So when you try to balance it now, the background goes darker because there's a lot of light on her face. You understand? Yeah, maybe this one. So, yeah, this one as well. Yeah, this one. No. Yeah, this one. So altogether we have about 42 pictures. Yeah, this. So when we crop this now, we're gonna crop this part away, crop the top part away, and then it's a good one. So overall, we have like 42 pictures. So we've run. Oh, no. We have less than that actually. All the ones I took yesterday is here.
Let me just quickly remove this.
Okay, so we have about 30 pictures altogether. It's not a bad one. Of course, on a normal day, this will still go down to about maybe 20, 15 pictures. But the whole idea is that you shoot exhaustively, so you have enough to pick from, you know. Forget all your concept, forget all your... That may not work. If you have the time, yes, but if you don't, just, you know, get the moment and get the best out of it. So, yeah, that's it. Any question? Just one question.
Just one question, and then we are done.
Okay, because everything we just did here is practical. You know, I noticed you are the only one shooting.
Yeah.
There's nobody else disturbing you.
Yeah.
So, what do you do in a situation like this where you have other photographers, like 2, 3, 4, probably 5 scrambling with you to get the same shots you are trying to get? What do you do in that kind of situation when you don't have all the space to yourself alone? You're shooting, you have a light man. Now in a situation where somebody is blocking your light man, you're on the other side. How do you handle that kind of scenario?
Okay, so because this is Nigeria, right? And this is what the couple want. Whether it's going to win their wedding pictures or not, they don't mind. If you educate them, even sometimes they still get like four photography team to come and document them. So all you just try to do is to try and avoid them. And if you can't avoid them, the other videographers and photographers are also part of the stories. So you just take it like that, you know. There was only one picture that I did where everybody was getting into the shot and I couldn't get a wide enough shot. So after the light and, you know, but the fog was still right there, I ran to the back and then I captured everybody with their light and umbrella, and that was the backdrop of of the picture, and I really like it, you know. So the truth, the reality is that you may not be able to avoid those guys. That's why the light guys. So what I usually do is, and that's why I shoot a lot, like I'm crazy sometimes, because you get the proper shot, and then they walk into it, and then they are out, and then there's no moment again. But so you just keep shooting until Jesus comes, until that moment eventually ends. At least you have one picture that is good from that memory, you get from that scene. Because you can't avoid them. Before, I used to say, too many people, I used to just grumble, you will not have the best time of yourself. You just think that this photography is killing you, you are not getting what you want, blah, blah, blah. You just have to tell yourself the reality that, you can't avoid them. And then when I work in Lagos, there are some people particularly that I work with all the time, that we know how we manage ourselves. Like Larry Eshona, I know how to manage him. Ladi Milan, I know how to manage him. Cinematics, all those guys, I know how to manage them. But there are some people that you've not worked with before, that they don't know you, you know. There are some people that also, when I shoot with them, they complain that I'm always right in the face of the client. We just have to manage ourselves to get the best out of the scene, you know. I don't think it will stop being like that anyways. But now that there's COVID, a lot of couple are just hiring just one photography team, maybe because the audience is not as much. And it's beautiful, but again, it becomes boring because all the normal lotteries that we all do before is not there again. So, yeah.
Thank you so much. Let's put your hands together for a moment, and thank you so much.
Powered by BROADNET Concepts.